Why is this happening? Russian and Ukrainian history. Located to the east is the contentious region of Donbas and its very rough and chaotic history. Tribalism and war for resources have plagued these people since recorded history. Its 6,500 square miles is equivalent to the size of Connecticut, and coal is in abundance. Roving tribes and invaders like the Scythians, Alans, Huns, Bulgars, Pechenegs, Kipchaks, Turco-Mongols, Tatars, and Nagas reduced stability for years. In 1918, Ukraine brought the region into its sphere of control but was soon incorporated into the Ukrainian Soviet Socialist Republic due to the Russian Civil War. The Donbas region is home to huge energy reserves and was a central target for Hitler and Nazi Germany. Without securing these readily available resources, the German thrust was bound to stall. Currently, the region is recognized internationally as a part of Ukraine, but in 2014 the region's de facto administration was that of a People's Republic which collaborates with pro-Russian ideals. According to the 2001 Ukrainian census, Donetsk was the fifth largest city in Ukraine. The population was estimated at 905,364 in the city core, with over 2 million in the metropolitan area. The operational plan for Putin is to gain more buffer to edge against what the regime sees as NATO overexpansion. With the strategic position of Crimea and its lucrative trade hub, a simple pincer without a heavy death toll gets what they want. The plan has similarities to Hitler's claims in the Sudetenland. This region has no significance to NATO other than its current humanitarian plight. Russia, in general, has had a much different history than our American and Western European ties have had. Its earliest origins united a Finnish, Scandinavian, and Slavic regime which found peace and prosperity as a unified front. Prior to that, the wilds of the unknown were dark and bleak. Some of the most brutal tribes and warrior bands terrorized much of the open lands. Few frontier forts or lines of communication existed even at the height of the Roman Empire. At its core, Russia has been Christian since the 900s when Slavic peoples synthesized with Byzantine peoples. The fierce nomadic Scythian, Seljuk, and Uralic tribes were far more formidable than anything the Roman Empire faced. In addition to the steppe peoples, the Mongolian invasions of the 1200s were extremely disruptive. But the lack of centralized Mongolian authority and fractured internal relations allowed Moscow to formally unify. Autocratic rule existed since the 1500s and carried along the ideals of empire until the 1900s. In fact, they believed in the Roman model so much that they named their leadership Tsar with respect to Caesar. No one has ever come to the rescue or save these culturally similar people. They basically face large-scale military strength and invasion since the beginning. The only period of progress and relative peace came under a solid unification and centralized leadership. By 1917, however, the autocratic structure was undermined by liberals and socialists. Tsar Nicholas II was the last Romanov emperor, ruling from 1894 until March of 1917. He was a weak ruler to begin with, and his bloodline hadn't prepared him well. His abdication seemed inevitable, especially in light of the eroding military strength. His entire family was bayoneted, and the bulwarks against Bolsheviks began to form. Destroying the monarchy was necessary, but the revolution failed to spark a utopia. Instead, the hard-line Bolsheviks led by Lenin and Trotsky seized power and established the dictatorship of the proletariat. Other European monarchs realized the threat of the common worker. They got very scared of being overthrown in the same way. In my opinion, NATO wants Ukraine to be independent or neutral. If they were in NATO now, we would be seeing sparks of World War III. And if I may quote, maybe Einstein, I do not know what weapons will be used in World War III, but World War IV will be fought with sticks and stones. This current invasion and failure will strengthen the people's resolve and warrant the inevitable inclusion of Ukraine into the EU and NATO. This current event in Ukraine appears as though we are coming to the aid of a distraught people, as opposed to the claims of Russia to say NATO is always overextended and threatening. Eventually, nukes and nuke interceptors will be in place, and the Eurasian continent will be one step closer to.
I know there's no such thing as either of He's trying to say, in any way, Putin is scared of Joe Biden, that Joe Biden is like dominating Putin. You can't possibly believe.